and I, we've cracked the code. We count our dollars on the train to the party, and everyone who knows us knows that we're fine with this. We didn't come for money, but every song's like gold teeth, grey goose dripping in the bathroom, blood stains, ball gowns, trash in the hotel room. We don't care. We're driving Cadillacs in our dreams, but everybody's like crystal, Maybach, diamonds on your timepiece, jet planes, islands, tigers on a gold leash. We don't care. We aren't caught up in your love affair, and we'll never be royal. It's the one in our blood. That kind of love's just ain't for us. We crave a different kind of buzz. Let me be your ruler. You can call me Queen Bee, and baby I'll rule. Let me live that fantasy. We're better than we ever dreamed, and I'm in love with being queen.
Oh, dress, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beauty focus EOU. Ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. My acres of a land I've achieved. It may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Ooh, for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you owe me, then all of this will go away. My many artifacts, the list goes on. If you just say the words, I'll up and run. Oh, to you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Oh, to you, ooh, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you owe me, then all of this will go away. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. If you take my hand, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd lose it all. Ooh, for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd lose it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you owe me, then all of this will go. My hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beautiful Castillo, you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Ooh, for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all.
Ghosted I too, but I waited it out for you. I wish I knew the way things were between us. I'm broken, I beg it better to yours. Every time I think I know you, I'm trying to stay cool.
I can get you off of my mind. so this could be a cruel summer or a real lover. Tell me how you want it to go.
Something just like lips, the testaments they told, the moon and its eclipse, and Superman unrolls a suit before he lived. But I'm not the kind of person that it fits. She said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something I can turn to, somebody I can miss. I want something just like this.
Like a heartbeat skip, like an like when I close my eyes. Yeah. ricochet, you take your aim, fire away.
We'll be right back. Good evening. Would everyone please rise and welcome Amanda Enriquez as she sings the national anthem.
Early light was so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets regular, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say those that star-spangled banner, yeah, wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you. Wow. Please be seated. District committee members, honored guests, administration, faculty, parents, family members, friends, and most important, this amazing Greater Lawrence Technical School class of 2023, bienvenidos, good evening. Thank you for joining us as we celebrate the accomplishments here tonight of the class of 2023. My name is Susan Zielinski, and I'm the proud principal here at Greater Lawrence Technical School. It is my pleasure this evening to introduce our honored guests seated on the stage. Our district committee members, Marilyn Fitzgerald, assistant treasurer from the town of Andover, Leo LaMontagne, chairperson from the city of Lawrence, Vivian Marmol from the city of Lawrence, Francisco Cirillo from the city of Methuen, Thomas Haydom, vice chairperson from the city of Methuen, and William Tarbox from the town of North Andover. We are also fortunate to have honored guests join us this evening. State Representative Frank Moran, the Honorable Mayor of Lawrence, Brian DePena, City Councilor Anna Levy, and many other councilors joining us this evening. We are excited to have a special returning Reggie, Elizabeth Bennett, Associate Commissioner of College, Career, and Technical Education at the Mass Department of Elementary and Secondary Education as our keynote speaker this evening. Before we proceed, I would also like to give special recognition to our retiring faculty and staff members this year. Math teacher, Marina Altherio, dental assisting teacher, Diane Doucette, and electrical teacher, Charlie Kennedy. Thank you. This is a special night for the entire Greater Lawrence community as we gather here for the 2023 graduation ceremony. Seniors, as you are wrapping up your freshman year in high school, your entire lives and school experiences changed dramatically as we entered into a global pandemic. The onset of the pandemic forced you into an ever-changing learning environment. Through it all, you learned to navigate a newly chosen career area and the demands of online learning while building new relationships with teachers, coaches, and fellow students. As students, you were all flexible and took advantages of opportunities as they presented themselves. On your return, you brought back sports, clubs, and many other of high school events. As seniors, you adjusted to our new schedule, and adapting to it was easy, since this was at least your sixth schedule change you endured within your 4 years. Earlier this week, when I asked GLTS faculty and staff members to describe this graduating class, they share with me, "This is a group of students who embrace each other's differences and celebrate each person for what and who they are. This class is of stopping, starting, and then running. Stopping due to COVID, learning to start up again, socially, emotionally, and academically, and now they are running towards their next steps and not looking back." Additionally, here are 23 words used to describe you, the class of 2023, by our faculty and staff: adaptable, brave, caring, courageous, committed, compassionate, determined, endearing, funny, gracious, humble, introspective, kind, warm, motivated, respectful, resilient, skillful, spirited, supportive, thoughtful, and united. United as evidence in the slogan from your senior year, "We are better together. Juntos somos mejores." These qualities and characteristics are what got you here tonight and will also continue to serve you as you leave here tonight to begin the next phase of your journey. Please remember to thank all of the people who have been by your side throughout your high school career for their continued love and support. Seniors, my advice to you tonight is to forge your own path, make your own opportunities, and believe in yourself. I'd like to share some excerpts from Craig Dorfman's children's book, I Knew You Could, a book for all the stops in your life. Reggie's, we know you can. First of all, you must find your own track so you can start right away and not be held back. But which track is yours, well, that all depends on which way it's going and where it might end. Reggie's, stay curious and open. Different tracks wind around, over, under, and through. So pick out the one that works best for you. Though the track you start out on will feel like the one, you might take a few more before you are done. And now, with your eyes on your new destination, start up your wheels and roll out of this station. Reggie's, be resilient. You'll go through tunnels surrounded by dark, and you'll wish for a light or even a spark. You might get scared or a little bit sad, wondering if maybe your track has gone bad. So here's some advice to help ease your doubt. The track you took in must also go out. So steady yourself and just keep on going. Before you know it, some light will be showing. And then you'll be out heading to a new place, ready for the next tunnel you may face. Reggie's, be proud of who you are. Don't be afraid to toot your own horn. If you need to be heard or there are people to warn, or being yourself just makes you so proud that you want to share it and sing it out loud. Reggie's, be open to new connections. You'll follow your track through twists and through bends and stop at new stops and pick up new friends. They'll all come aboard with smiles and greetings. You'll have such great times with the new people you'll be meeting. Reggie's, accept support, offer support. On the days when you're sad and feel you can't go, speak up and ask a friend for a tow. That's what friends do, so don't be afraid. You do the same if your friend needed aid. Reggie's, take care of yourself. If you rush forward, as a general rule, before you arrive, you will run out of fuel. Don't overwork, but save up your strength. That way, every day, you can travel great lengths. You'll need all the strength on the days when you're stuck, or tired, or sad, or just out of luck. When your belief in yourself doesn't feel so pure, and your I think I can doesn't sound so sure. Reggie's, believe in yourself. There's more about life that you'll learn as you go, because figuring things out on your own helps you grow. Just trust in yourself, and you'll climb every hill. Say, I think I can, and you know what? You will. Seniors, we see you, we believe in you, and we cannot wait to see where your journey will take you. Congratulations and best wishes. It is now my honor and privilege to introduce to you our Superintendent Director, Mr. John Lavoy, also a proud graduate of Greater Lawrence Technical School. Please also join me in congratulating Superintendent Lavoy for completing his 50th year of service in vocational education.
Thank you, Principal Zielinski. Good evening, welcome, special guests, district school committee members, administrators, faculty, parents, grandparents, family, and friends. I would also like to give a special welcome to our keynote speaker, Elizabeth Bennett, Associate Commissioner for College, Career, and Technical Education at the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education. As superintendent of this amazing institution, it is an honor and privilege to stand before you today and address you on this momentous occasion. Tonight, we celebrate the class of 2023, the 56th graduating class of Greater Lawrence Technical School. Graduates, you will soon become an alumnus, and as a member of the graduating class of 1968, I am proud and happy to welcome you to our community of Greater Lawrence Technical School alumni. There has never been a graduating class with more opportunities to put into practice the knowledge and skills you have learned. The demands in business and industry for your talents have never been greater than today. It is a great time to be a GLTS graduate. Congratulations, class of 2023. You have met the expectations of a dedicated team of educators who challenge you to go above your own expectations and to give 100% over the last 4 years. As I reflect on the last four-year journey that brought you to this very moment, I think about our school's mission, a mission you have accomplished. First and foremost, you are ready to meet the demands of the career you have trained for. And secondly, you have met the challenge of a high-quality academic education. Both your career and academic programs have prepared you for the rigor of a post-secondary education and the workforce. The truth is, many of you have already been meeting the demands of the workforce through your co-op experience and will continue on the path that now requires you to enter an apprenticeship program. When you complete your apprenticeship, you will be rewarded with something equal to a college diploma, a trade license. Regardless of your choice, I encourage you to continue the learning that you have started here at GLTS and obtain that degree or license that will allow you to build a stronger financial future. As you have already learned, education can open doors of opportunity. When those doors of opportunity appear, be courageous and walk through them. Today marks the day you must take more responsibility for your future. As Nike says, just do it. I believe that each and every one of you can do it. The fact that you sit here before me this evening says you have done all we have asked of you and you are ready to meet the next challenge of your life. This evening, we celebrate your achievements and the collective strength of your diverse energy and future pathways. You are the builders, the healers, the innovators, and the problem solvers of tomorrow. Begin that challenge by believing in yourself. It is not enough for me or others to believe in you. Success starts in what you believe. You have overcome the most difficult challenge any graduate has ever endured, including those presented by the pandemic. Being separated from your friends and having to use technology to connect with each other was probably the hardest. As you quickly learned from the experience, it is so important to be present with your friends, something a computer screen cannot replace. You connect better when sharing your common interests, discussing and worries you have, and your life experience, and sharing it with a friend in person. As social beings, connecting with others enriches your life and is critical to your mental and physical health. Last week, when your class got together in the Reggie Cafe to pick up your yearbooks, I asked a few of you, what is special about the class of 2023? What I heard was no surprise, as I saw it for myself over the last 4 years. I was told that we like, support, respect, and most importantly, care about each other. The difficulties of the last 4 years have brought you together like no other class before you. You have shown resilience in the face of adversity, adaptability in the times of change, and unity in the face of division. Don't lose the friendships and connections you have created. Stay connected and continue to support one another regardless of where your future takes you. If and when you are having a hard day, and there will be hard days, reach out to a member of the class of 2023. You will find they care. Cherish the memories you have made and the friendships you have formed. Graduates, what a great day in your life, and what a great moment for you. Great moments bring strong emotions. Today is a happy one, but can also have feelings of sadness, anxiety, as you close the door to one chapter in your life and open another. These feelings are normal for you, and also for your parents and guardians who helped get you here today. Today is their day also. Before I give my final words of advice, I would like to recognize a few courageous graduates who will be going on to the military upon graduation. We all owe them gratitude for their courage and commitment to serving our country, enabling us all to live in a safer world. I ask each of them to please come to the stage to be recognized when I call your name. I would like to present you with a flag as a token of your courage. Jose Evangelista in the Air Force. Miguel Gomez, we'll be going into the Navy. Anthony Basilio, U.S. Army. Xavier Torado, Marines. Kevin Rojas Santos, Air Force. Them a final round of applause. Thank you, gentlemen. Good luck in your future. Thank you. Gentlemen, when you pick up your diploma, there's a flagpole for you at the back of the stadium. In closing, I want to give you some final advice, graduates. Be an inspiration for others by always doing your best. Be a great partner at home and at work. Most importantly, be honest with others, especially yourself. Honesty is the first step to self-respect and happiness. I am confident that the future holds great promise for each of you. Again, congratulations to the inspiring leaders of tomorrow, the class of 2023. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce this year's recipient of the Superintendent's Award, Brady Dunn. Could you come up, Brady? Brady Dunn is the son of Mr. Chris and Mrs. Pamela Dunn of Andover, Massachusetts. He has a 3.88 GPA and is ranked 58th in his class. Brady is a student that has gone above and beyond to be a leader. Brady is an Eagle Scout in the Boy Scouts of America. To achieve this title, he completed over 20 badges ranging in difficulty. Some of these have taught useful life lessons such as life-saving skills, wilderness survival skills, social skills, and much more. He additionally had to participate in hundreds of hours of community service. This community service included conservation projects, food drives, and helping people in need. Scouting has offered him countless leadership opportunities from many different roles, such as senior patrol leader, assistant senior patrol leader of his troop. Brady is always the first to help out and is very dependable. He has always acquired an array of skills through his involvement in the automotive technology career area. Grady works hard in everything he does. He is currently working at a co-op job for automotive technology in the service department of Gervais Ford dealership in Ayr, Massachusetts. Grady will be attending Pennsylvania College of Technology in the fall. Grady is ambitious, compassionate, and would do nothing less than add positive energy in his future endeavors. Congratulations, Grady. At this time, I would ask the principal, Zielinski, to come back up and present the principal's award.
Thank you, Superintendent. I'm honored to present the principal's award, which aligns with our school mission, preparing students for today's challenges and tomorrow's opportunities, to Kate Saxon. Kate, come on up. Kate is the daughter of Denise Fitzgerald and Keith Saxon of Andover. She's a top student in our biotechnology program. Since her freshman year at GLTS, Kate has embraced and demonstrated our GLTS core values. Kate's an incredible young adult. She's compassionate, articulate, responsible, and an amazing advocate for herself and others. She stands out as both a student and a person. Outside of GLTS, Kate is a member of the Teen Advisory Committee at Boston Children's Hospital. Through this organization, she advocates for teens with chronic health conditions. As part of her role, Kate meets with teens and their families who have recently been diagnosed to help guide them through challenges they may face. Kate has spoken at conferences in front of hundreds of people. Evident by her work in the community. Following her passion of working with teens and families in a healthcare setting, Kate intends to earn her bachelor's degree in New York. Congratulations. Lieutenant Lavoie, back for the next stop.
At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce this year's recipient of the Valedictorian Award, Edgar Martinez. Edgar Martinez is the son of Elizabeth Burgos of Lawrence and a member of the Dental Assistant Program. Edgar has excelled academically throughout his time at GLTS, earning a cumulative grade point average of 4.46. Edgar has consistently pursued a rigorous academic course load, including his successful participation in concurrent enrollment classes through Middlesex Community College. Edgar was inducted into the National Honor Society during his sophomore year and has maintained this high standard of academic excellence for 3 years. Edgar was recently recognized for his outstanding achievement in English language arts. Edgar has also excelled in his CTE program, Dental Assistant. He earned his OSHA and CPR first aid certifications while gaining and developing extensive skills in patient care, medical record keeping, sterilization, and infection control. Edgar gained field placement experience at Dental Arts in Lawrence and was transitioned to a position as a dental assistant at Smile Design Dental through the Cooperative Education Program. Edgar received this year's Outstanding Technical Student Award for Dental Assistant at GLTS, as well as being honored as this year's recipient of MAVA's Outstanding Vocational Technical Student Award. Additionally, Edgar was a Massachusetts State nominee for the United States Presidential Scholar Award for CTE. Edgar has made numerous contributions to our school community as well. Edgar has been a Reggie Leader, MIAA Student Ambassador, Big Future Ambassador, Rising Leader Mentor, and a four-year member of our fall and winter cheerleading team. Egger was also the team captain senior year. Egger has been a member of Upward Bound, our school's chapter of Gender Sexuality Alliance, as well senior class president for the class of 2023. Egger will be attending the University of Pennsylvania in the fall, where he will begin a six-year program in gender. Egger Martinez. It is with great pleasure at this time to introduce this year's recipient of the Salutatorian Award, Jussi Ni Diaz. Jussi Ni is the daughter of Juan and Carmen Diaz of Lawrence and a member of the Medical Assistant Program. Jussi Ni has challenged herself academically throughout her years at GLTS, including successfully completing concurrent enrollment classes through Middlesex Community College. Jussi Ni has earned her certificate in CPR, first aid, and OSHA, and she has become a certified medical assistant through the Medical Assistant Program. She has applied the knowledge and clinical experience she has gained by proudly representing GLTS at a competitor at Skills USA, and she worked at Pentucket Medical in Haverhill through our co-op education program. Jussi Ni contributed to our schools outside of the classroom as well, participating in soccer for 4 years, as well as participating in indoor track. Jussi Ni has also volunteered at a number of school and community events and has maintained an additional part-time job aside from her co-op position. Jussi Ni was the recipient of the Rotary Scholarship and was also awarded the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship for outstanding achievement on the Massachusetts Comprehensive Assessments. The breadth and depth of Jussi Ni's experiences have contributed to her academic and personal development, including her exceptional leadership and communication skills. These skills will serve her well in the fall when she heads off to Salem State University to pursue a major in nursing. Jussi, congratulations. At this time, it is my honor to introduce a very close friend of mine, tonight's keynote guest speaker, Elizabeth Bennett. Elizabeth Bennett has worked in career and technical education for close to 25 years. She is a graduate of Tufts University with a CAGS in Urban Justice and Sustainability and a master's degree from Riviera College in Nashua in Educational Administration. Elizabeth serves as the Associate Commissioner of College, Career, and Technical Education at Massachusetts Department of Elementary and Secondary Education. The Office for College, Career, and Technical Education provides oversight, technical assistance, professional development, and data analysis reporting for policy and programs that ensure students graduate college and career ready. Elizabeth's background includes experience with workforce development and training, grants management, and educational leadership. Her focus has been on equitable access to pathway programs, particularly for students with historically underserved groups and communities. Prior to her time at the department, Elizabeth served as the Director of Grants and Community Relations at Greater Lawrence Technical School and as an administrator at Greater Lowell Technical High School. Elizabeth has served on a number of committees in the community, including the Massachusetts State Apprenticeship Advisory Board and Steering Committee to the Secretary of Labor, the Merrimack Valley Workforce Investment Board Youth Council, and the Advisory Board for the Graduate School of Education at the University of Massachusetts Lowell. Elizabeth resides in Newburyport with her husband Eric and her daughter Elizabeth. Elizabeth Bennett.
How amazing is this? I am so excited to be here, Superintendent Lavoie, district committee members, faculty members, proud families, and most importantly, the class of 2023. Thank you for this honor and opportunity to speak to you today as we celebrate with excitement this remarkable moment in your life. Today, I want to share with you what I learned from all of you about what it means to be a Reggie. I stand before you today as a proud Reggie myself, as I too spent 4 years of my career at Greater Lawrence Technical High School. I was fortunate to meet you, class of 2023, when you entered the school as ninth graders, and now it is such a privilege to see you sitting before me proudly in your caps and gowns. My time at Greater Lawrence Tech was special for me. I was able to meet students like you who were dedicated to their learning in both their academic and technical areas. Students who showed me what it means to be a Reggie both in and out of the classroom. I also had the opportunity to work with teachers, counselors, and support staff who recognized your potential, who strive to bring out the best in all of you. Educators who also exemplify what it means to be a Reggie. Class of 2023, let's take a moment to recognize your teachers, counselors, and support staff with a big round of applause. Let's also take a moment to recognize your families and friends who are here today. Thank you, families, for supporting your children through these past 4 years. You have been part of this journey. During your freshman year, the school was visited by our former governor and lieutenant governor, who asked me, "What is a Reggie?" A question that gets asked often. So I thought it would be important to hear from you. You, the students, who decided around the age of 14 to make the choice to be part of this Greater Lawrence community. You, the students, who despite a pandemic, were determined to persist through remote learning, recognizing the skills and knowledge you would gain from a career in technical education and how it would prepare you for your future goals. Alexi and Alec from Metal Fabrication. They shared a Reggie as someone who is hardworking, strives to meet their goals. It's someone you can depend on. Avery and Kevin from Plumbing shared a Reggie as ready for work, respectful and positive. These are the skills you will need to succeed, not only in the world of work, but also in life. Holneck and Talia from Health Careers said a Reggie always finds opportunities to improve themselves, welcomes a challenge, and perseveres through it. You, the class of 2023, have certainly shown this perseverance and have met the challenges put before you. John and Alicia from Horticulture let me know that a Reggie is welcoming and a friendly face, and Angelina, Edmundo, Paris, and Jure from Culinary shared that being a Reggie is being able to be yourself without being judged. Acceptance and belonging are the cornerstones of a welcoming community and attributes that will serve you well in the future. And I asked one of your teachers, a longtime Reggie, Mr. Victor Martinez, what a Reggie meant to him. Without hesitation and with a slight grin, he shared, "It's a state of mind. It's a love for this brick and mortar that make up these buildings. It is a persistent drive to excel to make things better. It's family." The exceptional education you have received at Greater Lawrence Tech has prepared you for success in both your career and for post-secondary education. Over these last 4 years, you have proven that you have the determination to face challenges and overcome them. You have learned the value of hard work and collaboration. You are prepared for this next chapter in your life. Just remember, the learning never ends. And from your classmates and what they have shared with me, you have also learned the importance of kindness and acceptance. You can make the world a better place, and we need you to do this. Believe in the fact that you can make a difference because you are a Reggie. In a few moments, you'll walk across the stage, receive your diploma, and become an alumnus. As you leave here today, remember, you will always be a Reggie. Congratulations, class of 2023. The world is filled with endless possibilities, and thank you again for the honor of speaking with you today.
I would like to invite back on the stage Justine Diaz at this time to deliver her salutatorian address.
Congratulations to the graduates of 2023. We did it. I want to thank the school administration, school committee, faculty, parents, guardians, families, and my peers for being here. I would also like to thank my parents for accompanying me on this special day. My name is Justine Diaz, and I would like to say that I'm very thankful to be given this opportunity to speak on behalf of all our graduates here as the salutatorian. It seems like just yesterday we were freshmen taking our placement test, and we are now seniors graduating and have done our time. I wouldn't have been able to stand here today without the support of my friends, my teachers, and most importantly, my older sister, Chrisangeli Diaz. She always pushed me into believing that I could be anything I wanted to be. I always strived to follow into her footsteps while growing up, but as the years went on, I realized what I truly wanted was to make her proud. And standing up here today, I believe I finally did. Many of you in the audience are feeling the same pride and love for your graduates here today. So I would like to say thank you on behalf of those graduating for being here on this special occasion. After 4 years of dedication, we finally did it. We can proudly say that we are high school graduates. I started this year wishing that the school year would rapidly come to an end, and now as I stand here, I find myself wishing to savor every last second. This whole high school experience has been full of plot twists, surprises, and unexpected turnouts. We have all faced a handful of challenges leading up to this very moment, and I would like to say that I'm proud of every single one of us for being able to do this. It takes an immense amount of determination and perseverance to continue to keep moving forward to make it this far. We have adapted to many different circumstances thrown our way through high school. We faced COVID, stress, heartache, and much more, but at the end of the day, we made it to this point. I want you guys to take a moment to look around and see everyone who is embarking on this journey with you. I want you to be grateful for this experience and excited to continue on to your new chapters. Our journeys don't end here, though. Some of us will go off to college and others will head to the military, while some stay and join the workforce. But no matter where our individual journeys take us, I know we are more than capable of succeeding. Many of us will move on to count the successes and achievements we make, and others will begin to count their failures and disadvantages. We have learned many lessons throughout our experiences here, one being how to adapt to the changes life throws our way. As we move on to the future, this is one of the most important skills we can take with us. Today is the day you make the decision on who you'll be. We are now joining the real world as the new adults of tomorrow. Will you be someone who allows the bumps in the road to defer you from the end goal, or will you see the bumps as nothing more than a challenge you need to overcome? And if you take nothing else from this speech, I hope you remember one thing. You can overcome hardship and still accomplish your goals. Remember, you are never too old to set a new goal or dream a new dream. So make every single moment count, live with no regrets, and most importantly, be yourself unapologetically. Thank you.
At this time, it is my pleasure to call up Edgar Martinez to deliver his valedictorian address.
Thank you for your words, Josny. Dear fellow students, staff, family, and friends, my name is Edgar Martinez, and it's an absolute honor and privilege to be standing before you today as the valedictorian of this incredible class. First, I'd like to congratulate my fellow graduates for reaching this significant milestone. The last 4 years have been quite an unforgettable experience, and I can confidently say that we've done an excellent job of overcoming numerous challenges and obstacles thrown our way. The COVID-19 pandemic during our freshman year disrupted our lives in ways we could never have imagined. We had to learn to adapt to new ways of learning, socializing, and even celebrating. But despite the challenges, we have persevered. We have shown resilience and the ability to overcome even the toughest of obstacles. We have learned to value our health, our families, and our communities more than ever before. As Nelson Mandela once said, "The greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall." So as we move forward, let us not forget the lessons that we have learned during these trying times. Let us continue to stay strong in the face of adversity, to support one another, and to make the world a better place. Looking back at our 4 years of high school, I realized that we've accomplished so much. As we take our first steps into the world beyond these walls, we are filled with a mixture of excitement, anticipation, and perhaps a little apprehension. But I am confident that we are well prepared for the challenges that lie ahead thanks to the education and experiences that we have gained during our time here. We've survived countless exams, made it through awkward school dances, and somehow managed to keep our sanity intact. And while we may not remember every single lesson we've learned, we'll always remember the relationships we fostered with our teachers and peers and the memories we've shared. As we embark on our next journey, we must take a moment to reflect on how much we've grown and accomplished during our time in high school. We've not only gained knowledge and skills, but also built memories that will stay with us for years to come. As we enter the next phase of our lives, it's time to celebrate and embrace the future with excitement. It's time to get out there, chase our dreams and aspirations, and make the most out of every opportunity that comes our way. So, class of 2023, congratulations. Our future is bright, and I have no doubts in my mind that we will go on to achieve great things. Let us look back at our time here with fondness and pride, and look ahead to a future filled with endless possibilities. Thank you. Se cayó. Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to say it in Spanish, of course. Lo voy a decir en español. Okay. A limpiar los lentes, que yo no veo bien. Okay. Estimados compañeros, personal, familia y amigos, es un absoluto honor y privilegio estar ante ustedes hoy y con esta increíble clase. En primer lugar, me gustaría felicitar a mis compañeros graduados por alcanzar esta importante meta. Los últimos 4 años han sido una experiencia inolvidable y puedo decir con confianza que hemos hecho un excelente trabajo al superar numerosos desafíos y obstáculos que se nos han presentado. La pandemia del COVID-19 durante nuestro primer año interrumpió nuestras vidas de una manera que nunca podríamos haber imaginado. Tuvimos que aprender a adaptarnos a nuevas formas de aprender, socializar e incluso celebrar. Pero a pesar de los desafíos, hemos perseverado. Hemos demostrado resiliencia, ingenio y la capacidad de superar incluso los más difíciles obstáculos. Hemos aprendido a valorar nuestra salud, nuestras familias y nuestras comunidades más que nunca. Como dijo una vez Nelson Mandela, la mayor gloria de vivir no se radica en no caer nunca, sino en levantarse cada vez que caemos. Entonces, a medida que avanzamos, no olvidemos las lecciones que hemos aprendido durante estos tiempos difíciles. Sigamos manteniéndonos fuertes ante la adversidad, apoyándonos unos a otros y haciendo del mundo un lugar mejor. Mirando hacia atrás en los últimos 4 años, me doy cuenta que hemos logrado mucho. A medida que damos nuestros primeros pasos en el mundo, más allá de estos muros, nos llena una mezcla de emoción, anticipación y tal vez un poco de aprensión. Pero confío que estamos bien preparados para los desafíos que tenemos por delante gracias a la educación y las experiencias que hemos adquirido durante nuestro tiempo aquí. Y aunque es posible que no recordemos cada lección que hemos aprendido, siempre recordaremos las relaciones que hemos fomentado con nuestros maestros, compañeros y los escuelos que hemos compartido. Mientras nos embarcamos hasta nuevos horizontes, debemos tomarnos un tiempo para reflexionar sobre cuánto hemos crecido y logrado durante nuestro tiempo aquí. No solo hemos adquirido conocimientos y habilidades, sino que también hemos construido recuerdos que permanecerán con nosotros para siempre. A medida que entramos a la siguiente fase de nuestras vidas, es importante que celebremos y abracemos el futuro con entusiasmo. Es hora de salir, perseguir nuestros sueños y aspiraciones y aprovechar al máximo cada oportunidad que se nos presente. Entonces, clase del 2023, felicidades. Nuestro futuro es brillante y no tengo ninguna duda de que todos seguiremos adelante para lograr grandes cosas. Miremos hacia nuestro tiempo aquí con cariño y orgullo y miremos hacia un futuro lleno de infinitas posibilidades. Gracias. Thank you.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for, the presentation of diplomas. I have the honor of calling the first two rows, and then we'll be joined by co-presidents Ariel Cabaretta and Edgar Martinez, and Vice President Lixanne Hernandez, who will announce diplomas for the rest of the class. One there. That line, see that yellow line? Okay, you got it. You got it. Yeah. Edgar Martinez. Jusni Diaz. Ariel Cabaretta. Lixanne Hernandez. Kylie Ann Lasky. Kate Saxon. Darielle Payano. Sydney Cuddy Reynolds. Adam Inkalingo. Congratulations. Iverson Infante Mello. Santa Joseph. Chris Merrily Lopez Burgos. Shaylin Marmol. Joseph Mastro. Darlene Medina. Lizbeth Mercedes Sanchez. Lily Monahan. Gianna Peluso. Emily Ruiz. Brianna Sapon. Estrella Villar Gonzalez. Hazeline Alcantara. Jalen Baldonado Vasquez. Angel Bodre Tejada. Kiana Caminero. Victor De Los Santos. Mia De Jesus. Gage Doobie. Junior Javier. Nathalyn Javier. Alitha Khan. Lorenzo Lopez Fuentes. Kayla Machik. Marilacy Montesquieu. Jaden Nunez. Braylon Ortega. Jalitza Ortiz. Jeremiah Polanco. Jeremy Polanco.
Dario Rodriguez. Sebastian Rodriguez. Derek Zapata. Jolisbeth Aresti. Juan Zapata Guerrero. Osiris Abreu. Cassandra Acosta. Juan Betances. Jake Bosco. Alejandro Burgos. Alexis Cabrera. Amarius Crispin. Wellington De La Cruz. Brady Dunn. Eduardo Espinal. Colin Grimley. Gabriela Ornedo.
I'll see the first two on the second page.
Jaden Jaime. Raymond Kenyon the Fourth. Orion Levesque. Janelis Miranda. Jordi Ortega.
Fernando Ramirez.
Mm-hmm.
Isaiah Rivera. Manuel Rosa. Jason Salcedo. William Tibbetts. Richard Torpy. Luis Veras. Charlyn Acevedo. Anthony Basilio. Noroli Delgado. Edierka Garcia. Wilfelina Guzman. Matthew Kimball. Stephanie Lopez. Rocher Matos. Alexa Pena. Alondra Polanco. Thais Ramirez. Yahaira Rivas. Kiana Rosario. Jalen Sanchez. Mabel Serrano. Tori Wright. Leangeleshka Aguiar. Woo! Ezekiel Alvarez. Tyler Boudreau. Cody Curtis. Jaden Dominguez. Leticia Ferrari. Jarius Gavin. Angel Garcia. Jose Guevara. Bianca Guillot. Jaleel Joseph. William Laurie. David Mambro. Kevin Mejia. Julian Menendez Rascon. Jaden Maranta.
Eury Núñez Torres. Leslie Peña. Adelson Perez Perez. Oscar Polanco. Elvis Reyes. Julio Reynoso. Kevin Rojas Santos. Jose Sanchez. Brooklyn Valentin. Anderson Ventura. Dinalis Arias. Brianna Brito. Jasneri Castillo. Emily Colon. Catherine Fernandez. Orlanis Jaime Silverio. Leah Marte. Anisabel Matos. Ashley Ortiz. Aliana Sanchez.
Julissa Tavares. Ismarlin Vargas. Brianna Aguinaga Alman. Travis Bistany. Paris Brown. Kejalis Class. Olivia DeLagos. Daniela Diaz. Jordalee Gomez. Wow. Diochi Hernandez Garcia. Jamie Hidalgo Munoz. Kaylee Lopez. Nayeli Mencia. Taylor Morales. Kariani Nunez Castudio. Chanel Pichardo. Edmundo Pineda. Lourdes Polanco. Angela Ponce.
She not here?
Siouani Quintana.
Emily Rocha. Dios Mary Rosario. Mariah Saito. Angelina Salak. Danny Salguero. Jared Soto. Daily Torres. Janelle Alvarez. Michelle Batista. Angelica Colon. Thank you. Emily De La Torre Sanes. Kariani Estevez. Francesca Estevez. Emmy Galan. Luca. Amanda Martinez. Emily Montanez.
Love you.
Jillian O'Neill. Jasmine Ortiz. Erica Paulino Sanchez. Leisha Pita.
Ashanti Reyes Ureña. Carmen Sosa Polanco. Jeremiah Acevedo. Ashley Arias. Juan Arias. Carlos Collado. Andrew Cursetto. Gabriel DeMaro Losowski. David Fernandez. Luis Garcia. Davy Gomez. Marcos Gonzalez Terranova. Javieri Guzman. Joherick Hidalgo Acosta. Christopher Jerez. Jason Lansleeve. Erickson Lopez. Juan Maroon. James McConnell. Aiden Minichino.
Miani Molina. Alvin Nunez. Reina Pagan. Reminson Pena. Jason Pittman. Eleni Rivera. Esmeralda Rojas. Marcos Roque. Anaris Zoria. Anthony Amato. Elijah Bodie. Joseph Calla. Alexis Kazmir. Jeremian Contreras. Yuris Difo Bonifacio. Crispel Espinal Lopez.
Camila Moja. Moja. Familia Moya.
Betnellis Familia Moja. Jaden Flores. Joseph Goslin. Jessica Javier.
Josue Ramos. Dylan Reyes. Jomar Tejeda. Yuriel Almonte Duarte.
Yordelis Almonte Santana. Honek Avilia Almonte. Michelle Cabrera. Naisha Cabrera.
Very much needed lights.
Johanna Liz Correa. Yanetza Cotone. Vidalis De La Cruz.
She didn't care, so it's fine. Mm-hmm. Yeah, cup is nice.
I did it! Alexandra Diaz.
Oh my god, tiene un poco de precaución. It's probably good. Call you the friend of medicine.
Luisel Espinosa. Angela Geronimo Quevedo. Jamari Hisiano Gomez. Darmelis Jimenez. Rosalyn Luciano. Eliani Lin. Jada Marshall. Aaliyah Martinini.
Kiara Morales. Elizabeth Aller. Bilexa Polanco. Carla Reynoso. Amber Robertson. Tile Roman. Ibelka Rosario. Nicole Angelis Sosa Núñez. Fania Suárez Nolberto. Ana Rochelle Webby. Jose Adames. Endel Almonte. Austin Altavesta. Nathan Coburn. James Cruz. Mike De La Cruz. Luis Del Rosario. James Falzon. Adam Gary. Daniel Gonzalez.
Gerald Gutierrez. Isaac Hidalgo. Yoed Javier. Angelo Joaquin. Jaden LaPointe. James Mahoney. Carmelo Marsac. Mark Martinez.